As of 4th July 2023, the prison population stood at 76,083 inmates, of which 72,507 were male and 3,576 were female, representing a prison occupancy rate of 374.4%. The prison population has grown to over double in the past 10 years, from 35,564 in 2012-2013 financial year to 76,083 inmates in 2023, representing an annual prison population growth rate of 8%. However, despite a drastic growth of the number of inmates in prisons, the Uganda prison's budget for food has not been growing, which is concerning the Uganda Human Rights Commission.
You gave them an amount X to feed a specific number Y. This financial year, you have still given them that amount X. But the number Y has since increased by 7.4%. That is the problem.
Why don't we entertain that discussion in EPO next year?
EPO next year?
Because if you are saying we are feeding 2 out of 7, can you first utilize the resources for the 2?
MPs emphasize that the right to food is non-derogable and no prisoner should die of starvation due to failure by government to allocate funds for feeding.
This is a human rights issue. And it arose from the report of the Human Rights Committee, Human Rights Commission. And the recommendations, what we are asking for are recommendations, human rights related recommendations.
Funding shortage is not by the only on feeding, but is also on clothing. It is also on eliminating the bucket system.
Musasizi made a commitment before the committee that they are going to consider a supplementary budget in the middle of the financial year 2023-2024, but urged prisons to utilize funds available in the meantime till the enhancement will be made.
We started discussing supplementary on 5th of July.
Yes.
No. The answer is no. You listen to me, please. The answer is no. Let's release for them for the quarter. We shall do quarter 2. Along the way, we shall know that there is going to be a funding gap, and which we shall provide.
In the current financial year, Uganda Prison Services requested 137 billion shillings for food, but only 78 billion shillings was allocated in the budget on top of the food grown by prisoners themselves, which is valued at 18 billion shillings. With the bad weather, prisons authorities expect their food production to dwindle in the current financial year, which is causing panic.
Prisons has been growing food, but as you know, the land that they are using is not increasing. And we have just noted that the number of people in prisons is increasing by 7%.
However, food is not the only item affecting the prisons. Other issues include overcrowding, clothing, medicine, among other items. Now, legislators demand that the justice, law and order sector address issues of case backlog and other related issues, keeping people in locks for so long.
We have so many people who have not been taken to court and who have not been given justice. And as we are all aware that justice delayed is justice denied.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.